In your lecture at the Humanity House, you also mentioned new donors, new or new type of aid agencies, for example, from the Gulf states and so on. Could you describe a bit of what they are and what they do in Syria at the moment?
Well, there's many organizations, and this is where Syria is very interesting, because there's many organizations that are that are coming from different parts of the world, whereas, you know, humanitarian assistance was dominated by organizations from Holland, from France, from England, from the US, and so forth. Very often also with clear linkages to the foreign policy choices of those countries, by the way. Nowadays you also see some bigger organizations coming from Islamic countries or Asian countries that work in places like Somalia or Syria or Pakistan, in Myanmar, and so forth. And these are new actors. We don't know them so well. They work with different principles. They are often working in countries where there's a direct interest of the country, of the government of the country, from where they are. And they often work in complete recognition of the sovereignty of the government in the place where they work. So they live and work with a set of rules which is very respectful of sovereignty of their own country and of the countries in which they work. And this is changing the landscape, because these are organizations that are gaining access, that are increasing their capabilities, and therefore we need to be able to speak to them, understand them, and they need to be able to speak to us and understand us, in order to find ways to collaborate in places like Syria, where there's not many Western organizations that can access. And sometimes they can, so then it's good for us to be able to establish working relationships with them, but also to have some discussions on, you know, humanitarian action, in order to preserve the idea of independent and neutral and impartial humanitarian action for the future.